Oh, my God. We have a caller on KBET Radio in Las Vegas who says he is a neighbor of the shooter. This man has not appeared on any other show in America. Is this true? Before I take him, call screener. We have a caller on the line from KBET Radio in Las Vegas who says he is a neighbor of the maniac who did the shooting. Rick on line 9, please go ahead.
Yeah, Mr. Savage, how are you today?
Are you really a neighbor of this maniac?
I was, yes, sir. And I'm no longer in Mesquite anymore. I'm in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. But I was his neighbor for about 7-8 months in Mesquite. And I can tell you 100% that this is not that kind of guy. I was there working and seen him probably every other day on my way home. He used to sit with his garage open and sit out there in his driveway with his lawn chair right at the edge of the garage and the driveway. And he would wave all the time when I was going by. Really nice guy. There's a little bar around the corner where they have poker vending machines where you sit at the bar, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You go down there all the time and sit there and drink a few beers and have a few drinks and play that little vending slot machine with the video.
Well, Rick, you're talking about a man who has just committed the greatest mass murder in American history, and you're making him sound like an ordinary guy who wasn't violent, didn't have any Nazi flags in the garage, didn't seem crazy to you. Are you sure it was him?
I'm 100% positive. I'm 100% positive. I know exactly who the guy is. I was in the Marine Corps, and I've talked to this guy personally. We drank beer together, not just in passing, kind of sitting there playing games together. I had another guy work for me. His name was Steve. And we used to go to that same bar after work and have a few drinks and play video poker as well. And he would sit there, too, and we would just talk about nonsense stuff. And I told him that I was in the Marine Corps, that talked about guns and all kinds of stuff. He never even told me that he owned a gun.
Did he express any political opinions to you in those discussions?
No, sir. No, sir. Not a thing. I mean, other than I told him, because I was wearing a Trump team shirt that said Trump team on it, and he was a Trump fan. But other than that, we didn't talk about it.
Oh, don't let that get out.
I know. But and then the acoustics, when you started talking about that, I was when I decided to call, because I know I've been fired at with a 7.62 AK-47 thousands of times. And I can tell you, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that is a 7.62 round. There's no doubt in my mind. You can tell, like your previous caller said, by the thud of it at the end of it and the discharge rate. 22 fires at a lot faster velocity and a more rapid recession than the 7.
But do you confirm that this was a belt firing weapon?
Now you have to be careful when you define belt fed weapon, because that could be a drum mag, it could be a belt fed from the side. I would say it was probably a 50 round drum magazine, not an extended mag.
Now, are 50 round drum magazines legal? Yes, they are. In some states, they are, and I frankly argued against private ownership of these before, and I was roundly attacked by individuals who call this program. I said, what the hell do you need a thing like that for? And, of course, the standard answer is we're going to hold off the U.S. government when it comes for us. But going back to your main point, Rick, and I need to confirm this. I'm just going to take you on your word, because what you just said has not been heard on any network. It's going to be picked up and played elsewhere. I know that. And, you know, thanks to the Savage Nation. You are a man who is a former neighbor of this shooter, and you say he was an average Joe, never expressed any political opinions. No religious affiliation. Is that true?
That's 100% true. Yes, sir. And I,
wow.
I've already talked to the Clark County Sheriff's Department this morning, called them and told them everything I know and everything that was said between me and the guy. Now this was spring. I was there in December of 2015 all the way until June of 2016. I was his neighbor for that entire time.
In Mesquite?
In Mesquite, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Unbelievable.
I've spoken with him multiple times. Now, I'm not a big conspiracy theory guy, but it don't sit right. I know this guy. I've drank beer with this guy.
All right, you're not a conspiracy theorist. Ordinary guy, doesn't snap. Something's wrong with the picture. Clean skin. Was he brainwashed?
I don't think so. He was too smart of a guy to be brainwashed, I think. You know, that stuff.
All right. So wait, you don't go for conspiracy. He wasn't brainwashed. So what is your instinct telling you as a man who's been in combat? Obviously, you have a very heightened sense of reality. What is your instinct telling you?
It's a setup. I know that sounds weird, but it's got to be a setup. What more? How does
Wow, wait a minute. Hold on. I understand what you're saying. That's the body they found in the room, but he may not have been the shooter.
Exactly. Exactly. I mean, how many movies have you seen with that exact same plot? I mean...
Oh, my God.
How does it describe multiple people running through the crowd? What, two people running through the crowd saying you're all going to die?
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, it's some average Joe guy who was an accountant who spent his days gambling at the video poker machine around the corner from his house drinking beer.
If you were writing the mystery novel, there are far more nefarious players involved. They did the shooting. They broke into his room and killed him and made him look like the shooter by laying guns in the room.
Absolutely. And he had been there since the 28th of September.
Yeah.
And then finally, on the last day of the last show of the concert, he starts shooting people. I mean, it doesn't add up. Why didn't he shoot people a long time ago? What did he do? Go out and enjoy his weekend and then decide he was going to kill people? Like, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't add up to me. Especially not this guy.
So you're confirming in your mind a conspiracy theory in your mind. We call it that. Call it what you want. That's the person they found in the room, but we don't know if he was the shooter, is what you're saying.
That's what I'm taking it as. I mean, prove to me he was the shooter. Show me the ballistics on his hands from him shooting and on his clothes from him shooting all these shots. On top of that, watch the videos. AK-47, watch any video from when we were in Afghanistan, and the end of an AK-47 in the middle of the night lights up like a Christmas light with a flash. Yeah. There's nothing coming out of that room.
There were no flashes coming out of the windows of the Mandalay?
Watch the videos. I've watched them on Twitter and on YouTube 100 times, and they're looking at the Mandalay Bay and a lot of these cell phones that people are holding, and you don't see a flash one coming out of that room.
Well, did he have a flash suppressor on the end of his weapon?
You're 30 stories up in the middle of the night. You're going to see something. I mean,
but why would he need a flash suppressor if he was just randomly shooting into a crowd? What's that for? Whoever was doing it knew that they would be caught eventually, but you're saying he didn't even do it.
I mean, I'm not going to say he didn't do it, but it's just hard to believe. It's really hard to believe knowing the guy.
All right, I want to repeat what we've been talking about, because I'm going to play this sound again tomorrow. Jim, we got to grab this. This caller, Rick, from KBET in Las Vegas, says he used to live next to the alleged shooter. He doesn't believe this alleged shooter did it for the reasons he described. And he's not given to conspiracy theories, but he thinks the whole thing was a setup and there are other individuals involved. Does that accurately depict what you are saying, Rick?
Yes, for the most part. I mean, it sounds harsh coming off like that, because it makes me sound like a like a weirdo, you know, but there's too much involved knowing the guy personally. So,
All right, weirdo. Don't worry about it, weirdo. This country takes weirdos to figure things out, but you're not a weirdo. You're an American patriot who's actually faced bullets flying at him from an AK-47. Rick, thanks for calling from Las Vegas. Well, we'll have to see where this all plays out.